Hi, my name is Courtney, and today I'm going to teach you how to make solution. First things you need to know is what is actually needed to make the solution. So, first off, we have a bottle of water. Now, the thing that's important about this is that you have to use either RO or distilled water. And then the next thing we have is the powder, and what you're going to need for that is something to actually measure out the powder. And then the next thing we have here is the liquid concentrate, and also you're going to need something to measure that as well. So now I'm actually going to show you how to do this. First thing we do is actually measure out the amount of powder that we need. And then you're going to go ahead and add that into the water. Okay, good. And then the next thing we're going to be doing is measuring out the concentrate. And then we're going to go ahead and add that in. Now, what's important is to actually follow whatever instructions you have depending on what wrap you're making, because everything's going to require something different. What we're going to do next is we're actually going to succuss the solution. You're just going to lightly pat it for approximately 2 minutes. You do it just like this. And that is how you make solution. So after you've heated up your solution and it's at a good temperature, you're just going to go ahead and put your ACE bandages into the solution and let them heat up for a little bit. We want the solution to get all the way to the middle of the bandage. Okay, so the next step in wrapping is going to be to measure your client. This is Christina and she's going to be helping us out today. So you start with the top of the head and then you work your way down. So our first measurement is going to be the jaw measurement. And I'll show you how to do that now. Okay, so I'm going to show you how to measure the jaw. Now, the biggest thing in all of the measurements you're going to be doing is that you keep the tension the same. So what you're going to be doing is you're going to be dropping like that. So now I'm going to actually show you here. We need to get to the other ear. So we're going to start at the base of the ear, underneath the earlobe, and we're going to come around the chin and make our way to the other earlobe. Okay? So there we go, and then you write down. And then the next measurement is actually going to be the neck. And where you're going to go is, again, from the base of the earlobe, and you're going to bring it just underneath the chin to the other earlobe. And the biggest thing is you drop it. And you write down that measurement. Now, the next measurement we're going to be doing is we're going to start at the upper part of the arm and work our way down. With all of these measurements from here on out, we're going to want to make a small line so we know exactly where we've measured on the person. So the client is going to hold out their arm and you're going to drop it so it's an even tendency. And then you're going to make a line on the client. And then you're going to write down that measurement. And you're going to go ahead and move on to the forearm. And the same thing. You're going to drop. And then you're going to proceed to make another line there. And then the next measurement is actually going to be the wrist. Once again, drop. Now we're moving on to the torso area. The first measurement is actually going to be above the bust. So you're going to have your client hold out their arms, and once again, you're going to drop, and then you're going to tell the clients to go ahead and put their arms down. Great. And then go ahead and make another line on the client and mark down that one. Now the next measurement we're going to be doing is under the bust measurement. And once again, you're going to drop, and go ahead and make your line there. And write down your measurement. The next measurement is actually going to be on the rib cage itself. And once again, you're going to drop, and go ahead and make your mark on the client. Now, the next, and then you mark down your, there we go. And then your next measurement is actually going to go ahead and be the waist. So where you want to go is right where the person's the smallest. So once again, you're going to drop, drop. And then go ahead and make your line there. And mark down your measurement. Now your next line, or your next measurement, is gonna be the pelvic bone, which is usually the belly button. And once again, you're going to drop, and make your little line. And then mark down your measurement. Now the next measurement is gonna be the hips, okay? It's the abdominal measurement. And you're gonna come down, drop, and make your little mark. And then write down your measurement. Now the next measurement is gonna be the hips and glute measurement. So what you're gonna do here is I recommend getting to one side of the person so you can actually make the mark, so you're able to see it. You have all the marks in the same area. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna go on the largest part of the buttocks and you're gonna bring it around, make sure you got a straight line going. And once again, you're gonna drop it. And then you're gonna go ahead and make your little mark. Now the next one is gonna be on both thighs underneath the buttocks. So you're gonna have the person put their legs together and you're gonna go right under both of the butt cheeks and you're gonna drop and then make your little mark. Now the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna do the entire leg here. So you're gonna have your client go ahead and separate their thighs, and what we're gonna be doing here is we're gonna do an upper thigh measurement and then we're gonna do a straight across thigh measurement. So we're gonna go ahead and start with that upper thigh measurement. You wanna get it all the way up in there. And you're gonna go ahead and drop. And then make your little mark here. And then I like to literally keep it here, but just go ahead and bring it straight across like this. And then you're gonna drop. And this is gonna be your next measurement. This is the upper thigh measurement. Now, the next thing we're going to be wanting to do is to get this middle part of the thigh, okay? So we're going to go ahead and get in the middle of the thigh, and once again, we're going to drop, and make a little mark. And then the next one we're going to be doing is going to be about 3 inches above the knee. And once again, we're going to be dropping, making our little mark. Now moving down to the calf, we're gonna go to the largest part of the calf here. And once again, we're going to drop, and make our little mark. And our final measurement is going to be the ankle measurement. Once again, we're going to drop, and then we're gonna make our little mark. And this is how you measure. And now I'm gonna be showing you how to actually wrap your client. So we begin with the feet. So I have my wraps over here, so you go ahead and grab your wrap. You're gonna start with the client's foot. And go ahead and wrap it around here. Get it around the ankle, and then you're gonna come on down. And then you wanna make sure that you pull up and actually get their arch, so their arch has some support there. And you're just making sure to cover the entire foot. And then once you make your way around the ankle here, you're gonna go ahead and put a bag on their foot, and that's gonna be catching all the liquid that's gonna be dripping out of them. And then you can have your client go ahead and put their foot down, and you're gonna work your way up the thigh now. So the biggest thing is just to keep a nice evenness here, working your way around. Now, you do have different pressure points on the body, and you want to make sure that you don't make it too tight in any of these pressure points because it will become uncomfortable for your client. And most women like to work on their thighs, so it's better to actually keep more tension here on the thigh to actually make sure you're getting this tight here so we get some good results. And then once you run out, you just go ahead and grab with your other hand out of the warmer and get your next bandage. And then so you're able to just keep going here, trying to keep the same tendency. Working your way. Now you do have another pressure point in the groin, so you want to make sure you don't make it too tight in that area either. You're just working your way up the client. You want to make sure you don't make it too tight on the back here either. You're just keeping a nice, even tendency here. Okay, so now what we're going to be doing is doing the next leg. So we're going to once again start with the foot. Have your client lift up their foot. And once again, working our way around the ankle, coming back, and just getting some good support there in the arch. And then covering the heel, coming up, back around the ankle, and then grabbing your bag. And have your client put their foot back down there. And we're going to work our way up the leg. Once again, not making it too tight behind the knee here. And maybe increasing a little bit on the upper thigh here, make it a little bit tighter. And when you run out of a bandage, you just go ahead and grab your next one. And you're able to just start right back up again, wherever you left off. Making it tighter in different areas that they're unhappy with. And then when you come to a stop, then you can just tuck the bandage underneath the next one. Now that the legs are complete, we're going to go ahead and move on to the next step, which is called the diaper. You're going to use some assistance from your client. You're going to ask them to hold right here, and you're going to work your way in between their legs. And here's the different technique. I'm going to go ahead and have Christina turn around here. What we're going to be doing is this is a butt lifting and shaping part of the wrap. So what you're going to do is really, you want to get a good shape on the butt. So you're going to start by pulling up in between the butt cheeks, and you're going to come back around the front and grab the front part of the wrap that the client's holding. Come back around, back through the legs, and then you're gonna go ahead and complete by really getting a nice shape on the butt cheek there. And then we're gonna do the next side. So I'm gonna grab another wrap. And once again, you're gonna ask for help from your client. Please hold right there, thank you. And then you're gonna come back in between the legs, and you're gonna pull up and really get a nice shape there. And then you're gonna come grab it from the client. And then you're gonna work your way back in between the legs. And you're gonna get a nice shape. And you go ahead and hook it in. Okay. Now the next thing we're going to be doing is actually posture. So I'm going to have Christina turn back around so you guys are able to see what we're doing. So what you want to do is come to the back of your client, and you're going to go ahead and have them hold this with the opposite hand in place. And you're going to come back and underneath this arm and up. And what you're going to be doing is you're gonna come right over the shoulder, and you're gonna have your hand in the middle of their back, and you're just gonna lightly pull back, okay? So what we're doing actually is we're getting the shoulders into the place they need to be. So once you have that pulled back a little bit, you're gonna come underneath the other arm, come up, catch that part of the wrap that the client was holding onto, and once again, you're gonna put your hand in the middle of their back and just lightly pull back. Not hard, just lightly pull it back. And then we're going to go ahead and just make the stomach a little bit tighter. We have extra wraps, so there's no reason that we can't be tightening up different parts of the body that they might be upset with the extra wrap that we have. Now the next step we're gonna be doing is called the skirt. And what you're gonna wanna do is have your client be able to have a wall that they can hold onto and face, or if you put bars in your shop, that's a good place too. So Christina, if you could walk over here, so you're able to have your hands on both sides of the mirror for some support. And then you're gonna have your legs together. And what we're gonna be doing is really gonna be tightening this area and also doing some more butt lifting and shaping. Okay, so you have the mirror here so you're able to see what's happening in the front, because a big part of wrapping is making sure that we actually have everything even, everything's looking good. And so you can go ahead and grab your wrap around, and this part you're gonna pull kind of tight, and you're gonna go ahead and pull it together, okay? And you're gonna come around, and we're actually gonna do a little bit more butt lifting here. Remember, never make it too tight in any areas. You don't want it too tight on the back or anything. So we come back around. We're gonna get the other butt cheek. We're gonna lift that up as well. And then we're just gonna come around. Grab another one. If you always run out, you can always grab another one. We just wanna fully cover this area, because we want the whole body to be covered with the wraps and the minerals. And we're just going around. Okay. Now the next thing we're gonna be doing, we're gonna have Christina turn back around. The next thing we're gonna be doing is the bra area. So if you have a woman that's wanting their breasts smaller, or they're wanting them lifted, you're able to do it at this time. So what I like to do is to hook the bandage in the back so you're not having to worry about it and not worrying that you don't have three hands or anything like that. And what we're going to be doing is we're going to be lifting the breasts. So we're coming across, doing a nice lift, and then we're coming back down, doing another nice lift here. And you're coming back across. And then you can even do more lifting if you'd like, really getting the woman's breast either lifted or if they'd like them to be minimized or anything like that. And then one more time, we're gonna be able to do that. So see, this one didn't make it, so we're gonna tuck it in, but we're still gonna get that other breast there. So we want everything to be even. We're just gonna tuck it in here again so we don't have to worry about it. And we're gonna come by. We're gonna do just a little bit, another lift here. And then you can come back down here just to kind of hold everything into place. Good. Next, we're going to be doing the arms. And how we're going to be doing the arms is you'll have your client hold their hand outright, and you're going to begin with the hand. And how we're going to want to do this is you can kind of just pull it underneath here, fold it over, come on by. So we want their thumb to be able to still be able to grab on the thing. So we're going to keep the thumb out. We're going to have a nice consistency here with our tension. Here's another area that's a pressure point, so we do not want to make it tight on this area. We're just gonna go ahead and come on up here. Good. And then we're gonna do the next arm. Once again, we're going to have our client pull their arms straight out. Get it under here, fold it over, keep that thumb out. Do not make it tight here. Then we can still tighten up other parts.
parts here with this extra bandage we have. And then our last step is going to be for us to actually do the head. Okay, so how we're going to be doing this is most women want underneath the jawline tightened, maybe some eyebrow lifting, things like that. So we're going to go ahead and start by almost folding the bandages in half in between your finger like this, just like a good amount of it so you can actually get underneath the chin here. Okay, so I just kind of have it in half so your chin will fit perfectly in that area. Okay, then you're going to come on up. And you're just gonna go ahead and, you know, hook that, okay? And then what we wanna do is we wanna be able to lift this area up. So we're gonna go ahead and lift that and come back underneath the chin. And then we're gonna do obviously the same to the other cheek over here. And then what we're gonna do is let's get these eyebrows. Let's lift up these eyebrows. So we're gonna go ahead and grab the eyebrow and pull up a little bit, all right? Come back around. And then we're gonna do the next eyebrow. Pull it up. We want evenness here. And then you have the choice. You can come back down and do this again. Or maybe their concern's a little bit more eyebrow. So you can get more lift here. You can kind of push back a little bit. And then you're able to just kind of hook this in here. And this is our completed mummy. So the next step, immediately after you finish wrapping your client, is you're gonna base them with the leftover solution that you have in your warmer, and you're gonna start with the head and work your way down. The biggest thing about this is actually just working back and forth with the solution. So you're gonna go ahead and get the client's jaw and chin area, and then you're gonna get the head as well, because lots of waste is stored in the head. And then you're gonna work your way down, going back and forth. Covering the whole body. Then you're going to do the back side, just the same, working your way back and forth. And then what you're going to do is go ahead and put a poncho on your client to keep them warmer while they're in the wrap. And then they're ready to begin exercising. After your client's wrapped, you're going to go ahead and put them on a piece of exercise equipment where they're going to be for the next hour. Now, a big thing is writing down their actual times, because since they're going to be in the wrap for an hour, we want to know every 20-minute interval. Because on those 20-minute intervals, we're going to be repeating the basting action that we did before. After 20 minutes of light exercise, it's time to baste your client once again. And how you're going to do that is just how we did immediately after the wrap, following that same exact procedure. Now, the only thing that's different this time is with these foot bags that are on her feet, it's time to actually empty them and get that liquid out. I recommend having gloves on. And you're going to go ahead and empty out your foot bag and then place it back on the client's foot and do the same with the next one. And then she's ready for another 20 minutes of exercise. Christina's now done with her body wrap, and the next thing we're going to be doing is unwrapping her and then remeasuring her. We just finished unwrapping and remeasuring Christina. She lost 13 inches in that wrap. Now, it is very important for you to keep practicing your wrapping technique, because the better you get at wrapping, the better results your clients will get and the better off your business will be. Good luck to you and your business, and thank you for watching the training video.